In this video, I will explain you how SAP user requests are processed in the SAP system. Let us read this section for understanding this concept in better way. The users can log on to SAP system using either the SAP GUI or a web client. Users of the SAP system can log on to SAP system using either the SAP GUI software, that is SAP GUI which will be installed in the front-end computer, or a web client, that is browser, Internet Explorer or Mozilla Firefox. When logging on via the SAP GUI, user requests are processed by the ABAP runtime environment. User requests are processed by the ABAP runtime environment when the user is logged on via the SAP GUI. When logging on a browser, processing can be done by the ABAP or the Java runtime environment. That means when a user uses Internet Explorer or Mozilla Firefox, that URL may be belongs to either AS ABAP or AS Java runtime environment. So that if the URL request is of Java runtime environment, it will distribute the request to Java dispatcher. If it is of AS ABAP system, it will distribute the request to ABAP dispatcher. And processing requests by the SAP GUI. Users log on via the ABAP message server, or they log on directly on the ABAP dispatcher. The work processors execute the user requests. Whatever way they are logging onto SAP system, the work process within the AS ABAP runtime environment will execute the user requests. The processing of a user request in AS ABAP, as outlined in the graphic, involves different processes on all three layers: presentation, application, and database layer. Okay, let us just go to SAP system. Just see, when we log on, just using SAP GUI means this is the SAP GUI software which is installed on the same machine. And this is the SAP server which is already started. All the work processes are also started. Here you see, these are all the work processes are started. And when we double click on this SAP logon and then double click on SAP system, as soon as we are double clicking on SAP system, it should contact SAP system. Within the SAP system, any of the work process like dialog work process will take care of this displaying the screen. So as soon as I click on, double click on here, so whatever the screen we are getting, that is with the help of dialog work processes available in the SAP system. If these dialog work processes are not started and SAP system is not started, you cannot see this particular screen. This is a screen. Okay, it will be displayed in the front end computer. Okay, it is the concept of logging in to the SAP system using SAP logon. And also you can use Internet Explorer to log on to the SAP system. Double click here. Here you can enter the URL of the AS ABAP runtime environment or AS Java runtime environment to connect to SAP system. Just we have seen this experiment in earlier videos. You can refer the videos how to log on to the SAP system using SAP GUI for HTML video. Okay, so just for understanding purpose, I came here. Just I want to show you different types of work processes available in the system from this window and different services available in this process list, that is message server, dispatcher, and gateway. So this is the dispatcher will take the request from the user. Whenever there is a request from the user, from the front end user, that will be taken by this dispatcher. What this dispatcher will do? This dispatcher will distribute the request to the available work process. If it is purely dialog process, it will be handover to the dialog work process. If it is a background job, it will be handover to the background work process. So simultaneously, all the work process together works to perform the particular user request. Let us continue the reading. So look at this graphic. Just now we have seen practically in the system how we have logged on to the system, just double clicking on the entry which is available in SAP GUI software, that is SAP GUI which will be installed in the front end computer. So all these SAP GUIs are installed in different types of computers in your organization. Okay, these complete GUI systems are called presentation layer. You can add any number of systems within your network to log on to the SAP system, and that request will goes to application level. Application level, there are different processes available. Those are all dialog process, enqueue process, update process, background process, pull process. These are all different types of work processes available. So these work processes actually performs the work of a user. User request will goes to ABAP dispatcher. ABAP dispatcher will distribute the work to different types of work processes. Okay, and then this work process may need some data for processing purpose. So when there is a data request, it will request to the database level, that is database level, and database is installed in this, and this is ABAP schema. Okay, all the DB processes are available in this layer. Just let us read this paragraph so that you will get some idea about it. The screen entries of a user are accepted by the SAP presentation program, SAP GUI, SAP graphical user interface, converted to an internal format and forwarded to ASABAP. Whatever the entries we provide in the screen, like example, I am going to the system again. Screen entries means, just go to here. So this is a screen entry. I am entering the user account here and typing the password. I will hit enter from my keyboard here. So when I hit keyboard, enter in the keyboard, it will contact the different types of work processes in the SAP system. It will allow me to login like this. Okay, converted to an internal format and forwarded to ASABAP. It is forwarded to ASABAP. So right now, just now we have logged into the ASABAP system. The ABAP dispatcher is the central process of ASABAP. ABAP dispatcher is the central process of ASABAP. It manages the resources for the applications written in ABAP in coordination with the respective operating system. Okay, it manages the resources for the applications written in ABAP in coordination with the respective operating system. Actually, the SAP software is installed on top of operating system, and applications are written in ABAP. All the applications are written in ABAP, that's why it is called ASABAP system, in coordination with respective operating system. So the dispatcher manages the resources for the applications written in ABAP in coordination with the respective operating system. The main tasks of the ABAP dispatcher includes the distribution of the requests to its work processes. Distribution of the user requests. Whatever the user request from the SAP GUI, it will be distributed to the different types of work processes available by this dispatcher. In the system, this is the dispatcher. Here you see, this is the dispatcher. It will distribute the work to different types of work processes available in the system. Okay, Okay, that is the main task of the dispatcher, ABAP dispatcher. And then the integration of the presentation layer and the organization of communication activities. The dispatcher first serves the processing requests in request queues and then processes them according to the first in first out principle. It will take the request from the user account and it will keep that request in the request queue, and then it will hand over the request to available work process in the system. Okay. That is the concept. It will work in the basis of first in first out principle. It is the principle. Okay, the ABAP dispatcher distributes the request one after the other to the available work processes. The ABAP dispatcher distributes the request to one after the other to the available work process. It will distribute the request to one after the other to available work processes. Data is actually processed in the work process. The data will be processed within the work process, whereby the user who created the request using the SAP GUI is not always assigned the same work process. Okay, one user is assigned one work process at single time and immediately it will release. So next work will be done by another work process. Okay, there is no fixed assignment of work processes to users. To process user requests, it is often necessary to read data from the ABAP schema of the database or to write to it. For this, every work process is connected directly to the ABAP schema of the database. Okay, ABAP schema of the database, it will connect. Work process will connect to the ABAP schema of the database. So, work process is connecting to the ABAP schema of the database. Okay. Next, once the process is complete by the work process, the result from the work process is sent via dispatcher back to the SAP GUI. It will give the information to SAP GUI again. The SAP GUI interprets this data and generates the output screen for the user. It will generate the output screen and it will display to the user. Now, the buffers help to speed up processing of user requests. Data that is often read but seldom changed. For example, programs are customizing data such as clients, currencies, or company codes can be kept as a copy of the database content in the shared memory of the application server. Shared memory of the application server means within the RAM, within the main memory, all the data which is seldom changed, often read, frequently it is read, but it is seldom, once in a while changed. For example, programs are customizing data such as clients, currencies and or company codes will be kept in the database, whatever the database content, in the shared memory of the application server. Okay, this means that the data does not have to be read from the database every time it is needed, but can be called very quickly from the buffer. It can be called very quickly from the buffer. When the data is available in the database buffer, it will be called very quickly, you know, like within the same instance memory it is located. So the data can be called very quickly. Instead of contacting to the database, it will take the data from the which is stored in the buffer of the instance. So each instance has its own buffers. Every instance will have its own buffers. Now this is the graphic. You see SAP GUI. From here the request will be stored in the request queue, and the request queue will be distributed to the work process by the ABAP dispatcher, and within the work process some components are there. Those are all components are internal memory, task handler, screen processor, ABAP interpreter and database interface. And there are some buffers, like here in the shared memory, that is from the RAM, main memory of the computer, main memory of the instance. Okay, here you see application buffer, factory calendar, screens, ABAP programs, tables, dictionary objects are stored temporarily in the buffer. Okay, so whenever there is a information requirement by the work process of factory calendar, it will be read by the work process very quickly instead of contacting your database. So database stores its data in the ABAP schema. So whenever the data to be fetched from the database, database interface will fetch the data from the database. Just look at here. Work processes execute the process logic of application programs. In addition to internal memory, a work process has a task handler that coordinates the actions within a work process, software processors, and a database interface. This task handler will coordinate between all these processes and database interface within the work process. Okay, the Dynpro processor executes the screen flow logic of the application program, calls processing logic modules, and transfers field content to the processing logic. Whatever the field entries entered by the user in the screen, that will be processed by the Dynpro processor, that is screen processor. Calls processing logic and transfers field content to the processing logic. The actual processing logic of ABAP application program is executed by the ABAP interpreter. That means any one of the ABAP program will execute that particular process. That's why that particular thing will be done by this ABAP interpreter. And ABAP interpreter also located in the within the work process, ABAP interpreter. And the screen processor tells the ABAP processor which subprogram needs to be executed depending on the processing status of the screen flow logic. The dialog work process selected by the dispatcher performs a roll-in of the user context first. Roll-in of the user context first. That is, the data that contains the current processing status of a running program as well as data that characterizes the user is made known to the work process. Characterizes the user means the authorization of the user, username, address, everything will be rolled into the shared memory. Rolled into the role area, shared memory, is made known to the work process. The work process then processes the user request, which may involve, for example, requesting data from the database or from the buffers in the shared memory. Once the dialog work process has processed the dialog step, the work process returns the result, rolls the user context back out to the shared memory, and is now available again for a new user request from the request queue. The result is transferred to the SAP GUI and the user sees the new screen. So that's all about user requests processed by SAP system. I hope you understood.